Lord Jesus, I speak.
奉主耶稣的圣名，我证道。
First and foremost, I give thanks to God for giving me this opportunity to be here to meet up with our brothers and sisters.
首先，我感谢天上的真神，让我可以在这边和弟兄姐妹分享他的道理。
So may the peace and grace of our Lord Jesus be with each and every one of us here today.
愿神的恩典和平安和在座的每一位同在。
So today I'm going to share with you an incident that is recorded in the gospel.
今天我想和你分享件事情是发生在四福音书。
We can turn to the Gospel of Mark.
请翻开马可福音。
Please turn to the Gospel of Mark, chapter 3.
马可福音第三章。
We read verse 4.
第三章第四节。
Mark chapter 3 verse 4.
马可福音第三章第四节。
Then he said to them, Is it lawful on the Sabbath to do good or to do evil, to save life or to kill? But they kept silent.
第四节又问众人说，在安息日行善行恶，救命害命，哪样是可以的呢？他们都不作声。
Jesus came into this world to spread the good tidings of the heavenly kingdom.
主耶稣到这世界上来分享福音的好消息。
We find that when he was in this world, he moved from one place to another.
那么发现他在这个世界上从一个地方到另一个地方。
Wherever he went, he taught the people the message of God's kingdom.
那不管他在何处，他都和大家分享神国的道理。
He also performed miracles, signs, and wonders on those who drew close to him.
那些接近他的人，他就显明神迹奇事。
So on this occasion, Jesus performed healing on a person who has a withered hand.
那在这里，主耶稣行了一件神迹，治了一个人，他枯干了一只手。
Here we can find that what Jesus did displeased the scribes and the Pharisees.
但我们发现主耶稣所行的，使法利赛人他们不高兴。
We know that Christ came with the standard of the heavenly kingdom.
主耶稣他来，他带着天国的准则。
He wanted the people to know about God and to know about matters of the kingdom of God.
他要世人了解神，了解天国的道理。
Obviously, men live in sin, was not able to understand the matters of God.
但世人住在罪中，所以他们不了解关于神的事。
So in this short passage from verse 1 to verse 6,
那在这边短短的几节，从第一节到第六节，
We can classify the people into three groups.
那我们在这边可以看到三种人。
The same message is also recorded in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 6.
那在同样一件事情也记载在路加福音第六章。
We can see this in chapter 6, verse 6 to verse 11.
路加福音第六章第六节到十一节。
So we shall focus ourselves on the Gospel of Mark, chapter 3.
但今天我们会着重在马可福音第三章。
So we are going to study these three groups of people.
所以今天我们要来读这三种人。
The first one is represented by the sick person here, the man with a withered hand.
那第一种人是像在这里这个枯干的人，是他们是有病的。
We know that he was a very pitiful person.
那我们知道这一种人他们非常的可怜。
He must have been seeking help from different people.
他们一定不断的在从别人想要得到帮助。
You can imagine a man with a withered hand, obviously, is like he has lost parts of his bodily functions.
那我们可以想象，如果一个人他的手是枯干的，那他的手就失去了功能。
So every time when he went out,
所以每次当他出去的时候
you can imagine that the people would look at him very differently.
那别人就会看他和别人不一样。
Some even perhaps mock at him as well.
那有些可能讥笑他。
So by going out itself could actually create a lot of pressure on him.
所以这个人他一定是充满着压力。
Because he was different from the rest.
因为他和别人不一样。
Because he was abnormal.
因为他是属于不正常的。
He was not able to function normally.
他并不像别人可以正常的行动。
The Bible does not talk about why he had a withered hand.
在圣经中并没有记载为什么这个人他的手是枯干的。
Possibly he had an accident that caused him to you know cause his hand to become withered.
那可能这个人他遇到了意外，所以他的手变了枯干。
Or perhaps he was afflicted with a kind of disease that you know caused his hand to become withered.
或者是他可能得了一种疾病，所以使他的手枯干。
Also very possibly he was born into this condition.
也可能这是天生的。
So in which case we find that he was very pitiful.
但是不管是因为什么原因他的手枯干，他都是一个非常可怜的人。
If we have not been sick before, we would not know, you know, the emotion or the feeling of those who are sick.
如果我们从来没有生病过，那我们就没有办法有同理心。
We are not able to empathize their sickness.
我们就没有办法体会他们的心情。
But we know that Jesus Christ came to this world to help these people.
但是我们知道主耶稣他到这世界上来帮助这样的人。
So in chapter 3, it was like a wonderful occasion yeah, for this sick person to have his illness cured.
所以在第三章这一段是一个非常非常特别的时候，这个人他的手得到了医治。
But we find that there were many people around him at the time as well.
那当时在这人身旁有许多的人。
We put ourselves in the shoes of this person.
那如果我们把自己当作这一个人。
If we have heard about Jesus.
如果我们曾经听过主耶稣。
We have witnessed his mighty power in healing.
我们也曾经看过他可以行神迹的大能。
Surely we would want Jesus to heal us as well.
那我们一定也会想要主耶稣来医治我们。
So it's like he was desperate, you know, wanting Jesus to heal him.
所以这个人他一定非常的想要主耶稣医治他。
So that is the you know the emotion that he was in.
所以这可能是这个人当时的心情。
Now you look at the second categories of people.
所以我们现在看在这一段里面的第二种人。
We can look at this chapter 3, verse 1. Yeah?
我们可以看第三章第一节。
We read verse 1 and verse 2.
我们读第一节和第二节。
Now, and he entered the synagogue again, and a man was there who had a withered hand.
第一节，耶稣又进了会堂，那里有一个人枯干了一只手。
Verse 2.
第二节。
So they watched him closely, whether he would heal him on the Sabbath, so that they might accuse him.
二，众人窥探耶稣在安息日医治不医治，意思是要控告耶稣。
Now from verse 6 here, we know that among these people were the Pharisees.
那我们知道从第六节可以看出众人包括法利赛人。
When you read the Gospel of Luke chapter 6,
我们当我们翻到路加福音第六章时，
The multitude here included the scribes and the Pharisees.
那众人里面包括了法利赛人还有文士。
We can read chapter 6, verse 7.
我们可以读第六，路加福音第六章第七节。
The Gospel of Luke chapter 6, verse 7.
路加福音第六章第七节。
So the scribes and the Pharisees watched him closely, whether he would heal on the Sabbath, that they might find an accusation against him.
七，文士和法利赛人窥探耶稣在安息日治病不治病，要得把柄去告他。
So by reading Mark chapter 3 verse 2 And also Luke chapter 6 verse 7, we can clearly see the mindset or the mentality of the scribes and the Pharisees.
所以从马可福音第三章第二节，还有路加福音第六章第七节，在这边可以看到文士和法利赛人他们的心境。
You know, instead of focusing on this person, this sick person who needed help so much,
他们本应该把重点转到这个枯干的人，这个可怜的人身上。
We find that they focus on what Jesus would do so that they could find a reason to accuse him.
但他们却在这个时候，集中精神在窥探耶稣，要想要抓住他的把柄。
So from here we find that their mindset, impure mindset, actually led them astray.
所以我们在这边可以看到他们不正当的心境，把他们带离脱往正道。
That's why they were not able to do good works.
所以这才是为什么他们无法行善。
Sometimes we find that You know, we are able to do good works.
有时我们可以行出善。
Even though we do good works in difficult circumstances,
我们可能在困难的时候行善。
Because our mindset is correct.
那是因为我们有一个对的观念。
Because our mindset is spiritual.
我们有属灵的观念。
We truly have the heart and nature of Jesus Christ.
那我们真的有像主耶稣的心境。
That's why we are able to do good works.
那是为什么我们可以行出善来。
Now, so on the contrary, we find that the Pharisee and the scribes, they were not able to do good works.
但相反的，法利赛人和文士他们无法行出善。
Because their hearts or their minds were filled with anger against Jesus Christ.
那是因为他们的心和他们的想法都充满了对主耶稣的不满和愤怒。
They wanted to find a reason to accuse Jesus Christ.
他们要找到控告耶稣的把柄。
So because their mind was not right.
那因为他们没有对的观念。
That's why whatever Jesus did, they disagree with Jesus.
所以不管主耶稣做什么，他们都是在反对的状态。
Because they just wanted to find reason to accuse him.
因为他们只想找到抓控告他的把柄。
We find that this is a very unhealthy mindset.
我们可以发现这是不健康的。
This kind of mindset does not promote love and kindness towards others.
那这种想法不会使一个人有爱心。
You find that, you know, Jesus had been doing this for quite a while.
知道主耶稣他已经这样行善一阵子了。
And also Jesus had demonstrated his power.
那他也行出了他的大能。
The scribe and the Pharisees have seen this power of Jesus.
文士和法利赛人他们也看过主耶稣可以行出的大能。
And yet we find that they could not bring themselves to accept what Christ has done.
但他们还是没有办法接受主耶稣所做的事。
Probably it was too shameful for them to admit their wrongs.
那可能对他们来说，承认他们自己的错误是一个很大的羞耻。
And to back down and not to accuse Jesus was something that they were not able to do.
所以对他们来说，他们并没有办法不控告主耶稣。
So this is a manifestation of pride.
所以这就是骄傲的象征。
That's why they were not able to do good works.
所以才是为什么他们没有办法行出善来。
So when we read chapter 3, yeah, again.
那我们再到马可福音第三章。
So we find that here, Jesus performed this miracle on this person.
所以我们在这边可以看到主耶稣在这枯干的人手上行了大能。
Jesus asked him to stretch out his hand.
主耶稣要他把手伸出来。
And so that we find that this person's hands were restored.
那之后这个人的他把手一伸，手就复了原。
Now we read verse 6.
我们读第六节。
Chapter 3 verse 6.
第三章第六节。
Then the Pharisees went out immediately, plotted with the Herodians against him, how they might destroy him.
法利赛人出去同西律一党的人商议，怎样可以除灭耶稣。
Here we find that not only they could not save, not only they could not save, they also wanted to kill.
那这边可以看到他们不但不能帮忙，他们还要除掉耶稣。
Because they were not happy with what Jesus has done.
因为他们对主耶稣所做的不满。
They tried their best to justify their actions.
他们想要用他们用不断的用借口想要证明他们所做的是对的。
So we find that in the process, they neglected the needs of the others.
所以在这当中，他们迷失，他们没有看到别人的需要。
Sometimes we cannot see the needs of others.
有时我们没有办法看到周遭人的需要。
Maybe our mindset, after all, is not correct.
那可能是因为我们有一个错误的想法。
Our mindset has to be adjusted with the Word of God.
那我们就应该回到神的话中。
Now we find that here, this good deed has been done.
你看在这边，这个神迹已经完成了。
Now think about this. If you are a person related to this sick person.
那假设如果你是这个枯干人的手的朋友或亲戚。
Obviously you will be joyous.
那你一定会非常的高兴。
Why? Because your relative, you know, who has suffered for so long, and now has been healed.
因为你所认识的亲戚，他本来在很长的一段时间都很痛苦，那现在他被医治了。
Surely you will be very happy about it.
所以你一定会非常的为他高兴。
Now we find that here the Pharisee and the scribe, they were not happy.
但在这边我们可以看到法利赛人和文士他们并不高兴。
According to Luke chapter 6,
那在路加福音第六章。
We turn to Luke chapter 6.
我们翻到路加福音第六章。
We read verse 11.
读第十一节。
The Gospel of Luke chapter 6 verse 11.
路加福音第六章第十一节。
But they were filled with rage and discussed with one another what they might do to Jesus.
第十一节，他们就满心大怒，彼此商议怎样处置耶稣。
How could someone be angry over a good deed performed by Jesus?
他们怎么会满心大怒呢？因为一件神迹完成了。
So this is something unusual.
所以这是一件不寻常的事。
It's not normal, yeah.
这并不是正常的反应。
A good deed is done.
你有一件行善的事情在他们面前。
Or a miracle has happened.
那有一件大神迹在他们面前。
By right, you know, they should be happy.
他们应本该高兴的。
So we find that when a person's mindset is not right.
所以我们发现当一个人的想法不对的时候。
He is not able to rejoice over the deeds of God.
那他就没有办法为神的工作而感到喜乐。
Just like in the church. Yeah.
就像在教会中。
Sometimes we see that many good deeds are done.
有时我们看到很多行善的事情做出来。
Even though the good deeds may not be done by us.
那可能这些行善的事并不是我们所做的。
But because our mind is right before God.
但因为我们在神的面前有对的想法。
So we find that whenever a good deed is done, we will become very joyful.
所以当我们看到一件行善的事情行出来，我们会非常的高兴。
That's why we find that sometimes our hearts can be filled with the joy of the Lord.
所以才是为什么我们的心中可以充满主耶稣的喜乐。
Now, because the Pharisees tried to go against Christ,
但法利赛人他们要和主耶稣作对。
So as a result, more wrongs were committed by them.
那因为这样子之后，他们所做的就是更多的错误。
Actually, this is very true.
那这是一个非常真实的事情。
So if our heart is not right before God,
当我们在神的面前没有一个对的心、对的想法。
We find that when this situation is not corrected,
当我们没有改善我们自己的想法。
What come out from us is cannot be good but wrongs.
那如果是这样子的话，从我们出来的都只是错，不会是对。
Just like the Pharisees and the scribes here.
就像是在这里的法利赛人和文士。
Worse still, if you see that here, they actually build up this enmity between themselves and Christ.
那从这边可以看到他们在。他们跟主耶稣之间，画下一个恨。
You know, and You know, sometimes we cannot understand why this happened.
有时我们不能了解为什么会形成这样的事情。
Such a wonderful work which has been done by Christ.
那主耶稣已经在他面前行了一个这么好的那么这个神迹。
How can this cause an enmity to be built up?
那为什么这件事情却引起了更多的不满，还有他们更多的愤怒？
Again, here it tells us about, you know, the hearts.
所以从这件事我们可以看出他们的心态。
You know, sometimes our mind can play tricks on us.
有时候我们会被我们自己的想法给骗了。
We think that what we are doing, you know, what we are advocating is correct.
有时候我们以为我们所做的，我们想要行出来的事是对的。
But if our mind is not right before God,
但如果我们的心跟想法在神面前是不对的。
Then nothing can be good.
那这样子，我们所行出来的没有一件事情可以
是对的。Nothing good can come out from us.
没有善可以从我们不没有办法行出善。
So this is the problem, yeah, with the scribes and the Pharisees.
那同样的，这就是法利赛人和文士他们的问题。
Now we look at Jesus.
那现在我们看主耶稣。
This is the third categories of people.
那这就是第三种人。
We know that Jesus represents those who.Do good deeds.
那我们知道主耶稣他代表着那些行善的人。
Jesus was a wonderful example of those who show love, yeah, to others.
主耶稣他是那些行善的人的美好的榜样。
Because Jesus was a God in the flesh.
因为主耶稣他是神道成肉身。
So he knew the hearts of men.
所以他知道可以了解世人的心。
We can read chapter 3, verse 5.
我们读第三章第五节。
Chapter 3, verse 5.、Yeah.
马可福音第三章第五节。
And when he had looked around at them with anger, being grieved by the hardness of their hearts, he said to the man, Stretch out your hand. And he stretched it out, and his hand was...Restored as whole as the other.
五，耶稣怒目周围看他们，忧愁他们的心刚硬，就对那人说：“伸出手来。”他把手一伸，手就复原了。
We can read chapter 6.
我们读第六章。
Luke chapter 6.
路加福音第六章。
We read verse 8.
第八节。
Gospel of Luke chapter 6, verse 8.
路加福音第六章第八节。
But he knew their thoughts and said to the man who had the withered hand, Arise and stand here. And he arose and stood.
把耶稣却知道他们的意念，就对那枯干一只手的人说，起来，站在当中。那人就站起来，站了起来。
Here it tells us that Jesus knew the hearts and the thoughts of men.
那这边提到主耶稣他知道人的意念。
And he actually could see, you know, the intention of the scribes and the Pharisees.
他可以看到法利赛人和文士他们的意念。
Obviously, you know, the intention of the scribes and Pharisees was evil.
那我们知道他们的意念是恶的。
That's why, you know, Jesus was also trying to correct them.
但是为什么主耶稣想要改正他们？
That's why he performed healing, yeah, on the Sabbath.
所以他才在安息日行出这个神迹。
Now I want you to look at verse. Turn back to Mark chapter 3, verse 4.
请翻到马可福音第三章第四节。
You know, some people said Jesus has broken the law.
有些人说主耶稣他没有按照律法。
We read verse 4, yeah.
第四节。
Look at the question he asked.
我们看他们所问的问题。
Is it lawful on the Sabbath to do good or to do evil?
在安息日行善行恶，那样是可以的呢？
To save life or to kill?
救命害命，哪样是可以的呢？
We know that according to the law of Moses,
我们知道按照摩西的律法，
The law does not prohibit anyone to do good on the Sabbath.
律法并没有禁止人在安息日时行善。
So it was permissible for anyone to perform good deeds on the Sabbath.
所以按照律法在安息日 在安息日是可以行善的。
Now we can turn to Gospel of Luke chapter 14.
翻到路加福音第十四章。
The Gospel of Luke chapter 14.
路加福音十四章。
We read verse 3 and then we read verse 5.
第三节和第五节。第三节，耶稣对律法师和法利赛人说：“安息日治病可以不可以？”第五节，便对他们说：“你们中间谁有驴或有牛，在安息日要在井里，不立时拉他上来呢？”
Here, Jesus asks a question in verse 5.
这边主耶稣在第五节问了他们一个问题。
Basically, is to tell them that they have been doing good or saving life on the Sabbath.
问他们说，在安息日是否可以救人，是否可以行善。
They have been doing that.
因为他们有这样子做。
They knew very well that this was not against the law.
那他们本知道这并不是不按照律法的。
So from here we can see that what Jesus did was not against the law. He has not broken the commandments.
所以我们看回来，我们知道主耶稣在安息日所行的，并没有触犯律法。
We need to understand that when Jesus Christ was in this world,
我们需要了解，当主耶稣到这世界上的时候
，He did not come to change the law of God.
他并不是来改变律法。
He came to manifest the law of the Lord.
他来是行出神的律法
，to allow the people to know how they should keep the law of God.
然后和教导世人怎么样按照神的律法行。
That was the intention of Jesus Christ.
那这是主耶稣他来到世上的目的。
So we find that whatever Jesus did was governed by the law of God.
所以我们知道主耶稣所行的都是按照律法的。
So I think this is something very important for us to remember.
那这一点是对我们来说，我们要好好记住，这是很重要的。
The law is not against us.
律法并不是和我们敌对的。
The law is for our own good.
那律法是为我们好，是对我们有益的。
Now we can look at a few verses in the scriptures.
我们可以读一读关于这点的几节圣经。
We turn to 1 John chapter 5.
读约翰一书第五章。
1 John chapter 5.
约翰一书第五章。
We read verse 3.
第三节。
1 John chapter 5 verse 3.
约翰一书第五章第三节。
For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome.
第三节，我们遵守神的诫命，就是爱他了，并且他的诫命不是难守的。
Here it says, "This is the love of God."
我们就可以看到，这就是神的爱。
The fact that we are able to keep the commandments of God, or we have been given the commandments of God, is the love of God.
我们可以看到，遵守神的诫命，这就是爱他了。
And the Bible says the commandments are not burdensome.
那圣经也提到。他的诫命并不是难守的。
We find that if we have a pure heart,
你可以发现，如果我们有一个正确的心，
清洁的心 ，or if we truly love God,
那如果我们真正的爱神
，then we find that the commandments are good for us.
那我们就会发现，他的诫命对我们来说是有益的。
The law is beneficial to us.
那他的诫命对我们是。是好的。
We know that Christ has not come to abolish the law.
我们知道神来到世上并不是废去律法。
He has come to this world to enhance the law all the more.
他来的世界上是更加的加强律法。
So you know in our life,
所以在我们的生命中
，whatever we do,
不管我们做什么
，we need to question ourselves.
我们都需要问我们自己。
Just like Jesus questioned the Pharisee and the scribes.
就像主耶稣他问法利赛人和文士。
Is this lawful? Is this lawful? 这是合法。
这是合法的吗？
Is it right before the eyes of God?
这件事情在神的眼中是对的吗
？Because we are governed by the principle of God.
因为我们是在神的律法中。
So when you read Mark chapter 3 again,
所以我们读马可福音第三章时
We know that by performing miracles, signs and wonders on the Sabbath,
我们知道在安息日行神迹奇事和行善
which is within the boundary of the law or within the parameter of the law,
那是在律法之下是可行的，是在律法的范围之内。
So he revealed the nature of God.
那所以主耶稣他行出神的性情来。
That is the love of Christ, that the love of God shown here.
那在这边行这律法就是行出神的爱来。
I think this is very important as well for us.
我觉得对这一点对我们来说是非常重要的。
So in our life, where we, if we keep the commandments of God,
所以在我们的生命中，如果我们遵行神的诫命，
we actually in the process reveal the nature of God in us.
那我们本是，从我们的行动行出神的性情来。
So that people can truly see that we are governed by the principle of God.
所以人从我们的行动可以看出我们是活在神的律法中。
Actually, the law is good according to Paul.
那以保罗来说，律法对我们，律法是好的，是善的。
Now I want you to read Exodus. Yeah.
我们读出埃及记。
Exodus chapter 20.
出埃及记第二十章。
Chapter 20 here talks about the giving of the Ten Commandments.
第二十章这边讲到十诫。
But we know that verse 2 here is not part of the Ten Commandments.
那第二节这并不是十诫中之一。
The Ten Commandments begin from verse 3.
但十诫从第三节开始。
Now we read verse 2.
我们读第二节。
I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
我是主你的神，曾将你从埃及地为奴之家领出来。
Now here before the giving of the law,
这边在颁十诫之前，
God spoke through Moses that what he has done for his people when they were still in Egypt.
神从摩西说出，在当他们还在埃及时。
Now here, we are told that God saved them out of the house of bondage.
从这边我们可以知道，神救了他们从埃及为奴之家出来。
So in Egypt, they were slaves.
所以在埃及时，他们是为奴的。
They did not have freedoms.
他们并没有自由。
They could not even worship God freely.
他们没有办法自由的敬拜他们的真神。
Because they were in bondage.
因为他们是为奴的。
Now, from verse 3 onwards, here it talks about the giving of the commandments.
从第三节以下讲到颁十诫。
We find that the commandments were given to help them so that they would not fall back to any form of bondage again.
那我们知道这十诫是帮助他们不要再回到为奴之家的情况。
So today, if they worship another god,
所以今天如果他们拜了别的神，
it's like they enter into another form of bondage.
那就像是他们再次进入了一个为奴的一个范围。
So if they kept the commandments,
但如果他们遵行律法，
they follow what the law says,
他们遵行神的诫命，
they actually kept themselves in the freedom of the Lord.
那这样子的话，他们在神里面就可以得自由。
Not only that, they actually made a distinction between themselves and those who did not know God.
那同时他们也分别为圣，把自己和那些不信神的人分别出来。
So that you know, those who did not know God could see that people here were very special.
所以那些没有信神的人可以看到这一组人，他们是不同的，他们是特别的。
That's why we find that as children of God,
所以我们知道，身为神的儿女，
we must be governed by the principle of the Lord.
我们一定要活在律法之下之中。活在律法的范围之内。
被神的道来管住。
我们要被神的道给管住。
No, I believe only in this way that we can live a life of freedom, a life free from sin.
那唯有这样子我们才可以不要活在罪之中。
Otherwise we'll fall back to another form of bondage.
要不然我们就会掉进另外一个匣子。
So whatever we do in life,
所以不管我们在生命中做什么,
whatever we do in the church,
或者是我们在教会做什么,
we have to ensure that the principle of God are kept.
我们要特别的确定神的道理有被遵守着。
Because in this way, we can keep ourselves in the freedom of the Lord.
所以这样子我们在基督里面才可以得自由。
We will not fall back to any form of sin.
我们才不会再回到罪中。
That's why we find that the law of God is very important to us.
所以这边我们知道神的诫命对我们来说是很重要的。
Now we turn back to Mark chapter 3.
翻回马可福音第三章。
Mark chapter 3.
马可福音第三章。
Now we look at verse 4 again.
我们再读第四节。
Chapter 3 verse 4.
马可福音第三章第四节。
Then he said to them, Is it lawful on the Sabbath to do good or do evil?
在安息日行善行恶哪样是可以的呢？
As we mentioned before, their thoughts were evil in the first place.
那像我们之前所提到，众人的心，他们是充满罪恶的。
That's why they did not permit Jesus to perform healing on the Sabbath.
所以才是为什么他们不让主耶稣在安息日行善。
But we know that Jesus healed this person.
但我们知道主耶稣他救了这个人，医治了这个人。
And to reveal to them what they had in mind was wrong.
由这个神迹显明了他们的意念是错的。
Here we can learn a very important lesson.
那这边我们可以学到一个很重要的的课题。
When we talk about right and wrong,
当我们讲到善跟恶时，
sometimes we feel that we should talk about it, we should voice it out.
那有时候我们觉得我们应该把它讲出来。
I think this is correct in a way.
从一方面来说，这样是对的。
But also, you know, in order to tell, to show the difference, we have to continue to do what is good.
但同时，我们如果要分别出来，我们要继续的行善。
So by our actions, we expose what is not good.
所以我们要从我们的行动来行出什么是善的。
We expose what is not good.
我们从我们的行动来
把那些不好的显明出来，
把那些不好的给显明出来。
Because we are God's children.
因为我们是神的儿女。
We are of the light.
我们是属于亮的。
我们是行在光中。
我们是身在光中。
So through our actions,
所以从我们的行动，
we reveal the nature of God.
我们把神的性情给显明出来。
So if we want to correct a situation set in our family,
所以如果我们要改善我们家中的一些事情，
not only we talk about it,
我们不只要把它讲出来，
we must continue to do good.
我们还要不断的行出善。
So that you know people around can see our good behavior.
所以我们周遭的人可以看到我们的善行。
Likewise, in the church, we need to continue to love and to show kindness.
同样的，在教会中，我们要不断的行出爱来，行善。
We know that this kind of action can stir up more love and faith in the church.
因为这样子的行动可以帮助教会的信心，然后可以使周遭人行出更多的善。
Actually, this is a very powerful means of teaching others how to love.
那这样子的行动对别人来说是很好的，可以帮助他们行善。
So we must be determined to do good to our own family members and to do good to our brothers and sisters.
所以我们要立志在教会中行善，在家中行善。
Just like Jesus here, even though he faced with opposition, he did not fail to continue to do good.
那就像主耶稣在这边。虽然有人敌对他，但他还是不断的行善。
So may God help all of you.
那愿神帮助我们每个人。
Let's sing a hymn.
我们唱诗。